Supercalifragilistic spialidocious morning madlang people, I am Sharon Jean Bulacito, 17 years of age. Studying in Davao Central College, grade 11 from section Forbes. Today, let me share to you my discussion about exponential function and equation. Before anything else, let me ask you something. Do you love mathematics? Well, you have to, because according to our general mathematics teacher, math is important, because through mathematics, it tells us that every problem that we will encounter in our daily lives has a solution. So let's move on. Since our topic is all about exponential function and equation, from the word exponent, let us recall if how to solve the law of its exponent. Law of exponent. So let's start. So if the given example is looks like this, it's in the form of a raised to the power of x times a raised to the power of y is equal to a x plus y. All we have to do is we will going to add its exponent, which are rather the x and y. So I will give you some example. So this 5 raised to the power of 2 times 5 raised to the power of 4. We come up with the answer of 5 raised to the power of 6. Why? Because like what I said a while ago, we will only add its exponent, which are the 2 and 4. 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. That's why our final answer will be 5 raised to the power of 6. So another one, if the given example is looks like this, its format is a raised to the power of x times raised to the power of y is equal to a raised to the power of x and y. So I will give you some example. So 2 raised to the power of 3 times raised to the power of 2 is equal to 2 raised to the power of 6. Why? Because all we have to do in this situation is we will going to add its exponent. Since our exponent is 3 and 2, so that's why we come up with the answer of 2 raised to the power of 3 times raised to the power of 2 is equal to 2 raised to the power of 6. Another one example. The given example is just like this. AB raised to the power of x is equal to A raised to the power of x and B raised to the power of x. So all we have to do is we are going to separate the two variables, which are the a and b, and each variable must be placed its exponent, which is the x. So I will give you some example. So 2x raised to the power of 3. So like what I've said a while ago, we will going to separate the two variables, which are the 2 and x, and it must be placed each variable an exponent. So this is the form from 2x raised to the power of 3 to 2 raised to the power of 3 and x raised to the power of 3. So we come up with the answer of 8x raised to the power of 3. 2 times 2 is equal to 6 times 2 is equal to 8. That's why we come up with the answer of 8x raised to the power of 3. So another example. So if the given form is looks like this, a raised to the power of x over b raised to the power of y is equal to a raised to the power of x and y. So I will give you some example. So here's the example. 3 raised to the power of 3 over 3 raised to the power of 2 equals 3 minus 3 raised to the power of 3 minus 3 is equal to 3 raised to the power of 1, or 3. Why we come up with this answer? Because all we have to do in this equation form is we will going to subtract the exponent of the numerator to the exponent of denominator. Since our exponent is 3 and 2, that's why we come up with the answer of 1. So our answer is 3 raised to the power of 1, or 3. Another example of law of exponent. So if the form is looks like this, a over b raised to the power of x is equals to a raised to the power of x over b raised to the power of x. So all we have to do is we will use our only one exponent to form like this, from a over b raised to the power of x to a raised to the power of x over b raised to the power of x. We must use the exponent in, beside the numerator and the denominator. So here's the example. So our given example is 4 over 7 raised to the power of 2 is equals to, we will arrange it so it will look like this. 4 raised to the power of 2 over 7 raised to the power of 2. So we come up with the answer of 16 raised to the power of 49. 16 over 49 rather. So that would be all for the law of exponents. How was your feeling after recalling the laws of exponents? Do you remember the past lessons that you encountered with your past teachers together? How was your feeling? Do you remember it? So let's move on to the properties of exponential equations. So for positive number, so for positive real numbers a and b, a is not equal to b. A raised to the power of x is equal to a raised to the power of y if and only if x is equal to y. So now I will give you some examples. Solve for 4 raised to the power of x minus 3 is equals to 8. So now our first step is next. It will look like this.